Today we will discuss the use of cryofluorescence light microscopy in the cryo-electron tomography or cryo-ET workflow. For cryo-ET, a sample is immobilized by rapid freezing in a process called vitrification. In most cryo-ET workflows, fluorescence microscopy is often used to identify regions of interest. In this context, fluorescence microscopy is performed after vitrification and under cryogenic conditions to ensure the highest correlation between the electron microscopy images and the light microscopy images. Cryofluorescence microscopy has a lower effective resolution than fluorescence microscopy at ambient temperatures. This is because cryogenic conditions inhibit the use of immersion objectives. In light microscopy, the high numerical aperture, or NA, of immersion objectives allows imaging at resolutions near the diffraction limit, at around 200 nanometers. In contrast, the air objectives that are used for cryofluorescence microscopy are limited to a lower NA and are therefore only able to reach resolutions of 400 to 500 nanometers. In addition to limiting the use of objectives, cryogenic conditions change many aspects of fluorophores. This leads to some benefits as well as some challenges for cryofluorescence microscopy. One benefit is that several fluorophores emit more photons at cryogenic temperatures, making each fluorophore brighter. However, this upside is cancelled out by the fact that about 80% of fluorophores are excited into a so-called triplet state, where they emit no fluorescence whatsoever. This means that only 1 in 5 fluorophores is actually contributing to the signal. Another change is that the half-life of fluorophores is increased dramatically under cryogenic conditions. This means that one can use longer exposure times to get more signal without bleaching the fluorophores. However, this also means that molecules in the cell that contribute to autofluorescence have a longer half-life as well. This translates in very high background autofluorescence in certain cell types. The last change that should be taken into account is that the excitation and emission spectra for the fluorophores can change at cryogenic temperatures. Being aware of these changes and taking them into account can save you a lot of headache later down the line. At Delmic, we optimize our integrated fluorescence microscopy solutions for work under cryogenic conditions. If you want to know more about cryogenic light microscopy for the cryo-ET workflow, you can always contact us or go to delmic.com.